an overdue step in the right direction for our stolen generations.
There are many survivors that have died waiting for this recognition, my mum being one of them.
In the House of Representatives, the Prime Minister announced the Stolen Generations Redress Scheme.
For survivors who were removed as children from their families in former Commonwealth territories.
A commitment of $380 million to compensate survivors and their families. It involves a one-off payment of $75,000 for harm caused and a healing assistance payment of $7,000.
It will give each survivor the opportunity to, should they wish, tell their story and receive an individual apology. This is a long called for step.
It's just one aspect of a billion-dollar pledge to achieve the closing the gap outcomes.
We seek to understand in detail how our systems can knowingly or otherwise perpetuate racism. The new chapter of closing the gap simply won't succeed without it.
Closing the gap in life expectancy, early childhood education, and incarceration rates.
I think it is a turning point.
So far, only 11% of the Indigenous population is fully vaccinated.
We need 100% vaccination of all eligible Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, no matter where they live.
Unsurprisingly, this week's return of Parliament saw Labor go after the Prime Minister day after day for failures with the vaccine rollout. And as sure as night follows day, you can bet the same thing will happen next week when Parliament resumes.
Isn't it the Prime Minister's fault that he failed to order enough vaccine when it counted? Time.
Full of negativity.
No, just the Prime Minister.
All opposition, no substance.
Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.